Well, friends, health is different from disease, you probably know. And most doctors don't know what health is. We are trained in the medical school for looking after illnesses. Thousands and thousands of them. There are books, yellow, but not a single thing on health. What is health is the question. Does anyone know what health is? Any of you in the audience? Health is wealth. That's right.
Health is the absence of illness.
Health is the absence of illness. Let's take these two definitions. First is health and wealth. How many of you knew that mankind was absolutely healthy before money came into this world? You don't know. There's a very nice study called the Innu Community Study. The study is so beautifully published, called Failure of Scientific Medicine, the Innu Community Study. Innus are an aboriginal race off the coast of Saskatchewan in Canada, who had no touch with what is called civilization, what you and I call a civilization. They were sort of an aboriginal race. They were all for themselves, and they didn't have touch with mainland Canada at all up until 1732. And they had an egalitarian society and a hunter-gatherer sort of a type of society where they all worked. Those able-bodied men worked and they distributed their food equally. There are no banks, there are no loans, nothing belonged to nobody, everything belonged to everybody, and they all enjoyed it. There was no word called I. There was only one word called we. The difference is very simple. I starting with illness, we starting with wellness. Innus had beautiful history written on rock, on leaves, and various other things, which graphically told about only two things that they died of. A, old age, which of course is inevitable. If the world has to go on, those who are born will have to die. Two, predation. But what happened in 1732? William's company, one of the trading companies from mainland Canada, came into Innu land and started a barter company. We will give you a biscuit, you give us the hide. We will give you this, you give us the hide. That's where bartering started, business started. To cut the long story short, today every Innu is a Canadian citizen by right. And would you believe every Innu is heir to every disease from common cold to cancer? Very interestingly, 10 years precautious to the Canadian Caucasian. Supposing heart attack is very common in the fifth decade for a Canadian, it's very common for the fourth decade for the Innu. What has changed for the Innu? After 1732, money came into their life. And money brings in a lot of problems. I don't know how many of you know, when the first industry started in Europe, to be precise in England, 1802, there was this romantic British poet, William Wordsworth, who wrote a poem called The World Is Too Much With Us. How many of you have read it? It's a very nice poem. Go home and read it. I'll give you four lines. The world is too much with us, late and soon. Getting and spending, we lay waste our powers. Little do we see in nature that is ours. We have sold our soul. I added two words to the devil, a sordid boon. Today, we have sold our soul in every walk of life. I don't know about printing. In every walk of life, we have sold our soul. And our aim is making money and making big money. Greed, of course, is human nature, but Wall Street greed is something that has invaded us. You know what Wall Street greed is? Greed for everything. Everything must be mine. I am sure you all know seven people in this world own 50% of the world's wealth. And 5% of the wealth is shared by 50% of this world. 3.3 billion people share 5%. I mean, is this fair? This is exactly what is called the Wall Street greed. Now, why are we now connecting money with health? And what is health, to be precise? Our friend said, health is absence of disease. Is there anybody here in this audience, including me, who has no disease? Anyone? Can you say, I have no disease? I don't know. Actually, there is no one without a disease. If we can scan all of us for a cancer cell, a mutated cancer cell, everyone will have not one cancer, but about 10, 15 cancers. But they don't kill you. They die themselves. But supposing I told you today that you have 10 cancers growing in you, would you survive more than 10 days? That is exactly why that definition came in 1947, which is called the Alma Ata definition of the WHO. You know what WHO is? World Health Organization. What is IMF? What is UNESCO? Do you know what these are? You don't know. Please get this book. You're a printer. So get this book called Perpetuating Poverty. Perpetuating Poverty. It's a beautiful book which is compiled by Cato Institute in Washington. You write to them as an organization, they'll send you the book free. Cato Institute, 1000 Massachusetts Avenue, Washington, D.C. 20001. And write to them saying that we are the Printers Association. We do good to others. Send us his book called Perpetuating Poverty. So beautifully it shows all these organizations are there to keep the third world poor. You're talking about this word science. Very good word. Science. Science. What is science? Knowing. What is science? Knowing. Knowing, you can know about drama, music, and that science, is it? Anybody? Sorry? Science is an experiment. The real meaning of the word science is trying to understand this nature. But what the science of present day, monetary science, is trying to do is to teach nature a lesson or two. That's where we have gone wrong. Supposing you don't have a child, let us say. You're married, you're prosperous, you don't have a child. What's the use? You try everything possible and then probably adopt a child. But today, the present science doesn't let you that. They'll give you a test tube baby. You probably don't know the intricacies of the whole thing. Apart from all that, we still don't know what happens with test tube babies because we have only about 5 to 10 years of experience. We are trying to teach nature a lesson because of money. I'll tell you a story, not a story, a true thing. A young boy got his PhD from MIT. Eric Drexler was his name. Eric was so proud that he had a PhD from MIT that he started a company. That's what happens. Science immediately starts a company, technology. Technology is science riding piggyback on technology for making money. The company's name was Futuristic Inc. Future. And he claimed that he can make self-replicating nanobots. No father needed, no mother needed. He can produce a custom-built baby for you. Just like in the olden days, custom-built cars were built. In the earlier days, Daimler, Benz, and the British Motor Corporation, they used to build cars. After you say, I want this car, it's built. Only Henry Ford came and started mass production of cars. Now, this boy claimed that he can make that. And venture capitalists poured money there because that's where the future is. Supposing you make human beings without any father, mother, it's a big industry, you know. This boy collected about $100 million in 1 week from venture capitalists. At that time, his own professor who gave him the PhD, who is himself a Nobel laureate, Richard Smalley, wrote an article in the Boston Globe saying that, forget about making a nanobot, you can't even make a DNA. So the company closed, chapter 11, and the man went home with $100 million. This is called science. Do you understand that? If you want to know what science is, from the Western scientists themselves, forget about this villager. I will give you a book. Please read this book. It's a small book, very cheap, but you must read it. easy to read also. Even a non-scientist, an arts student, as our friend claimed, can also do that. And this book's name is The Golem, G-O-L-E-M, The Golem. Oh, he's writing down, good. The book's name is The Golem. What is Golem? Golem is not an English word, it's a Hebrew word. Any Malayalis here? No? What is Golem? What? Oh, that is Golem. Anyway, The Golem is a Hebrew word. I'll tell you what it is, because the same in Malayalam also. So probably Hebrew and Malayalam have some connection. Written by two physics professors in New York, Harry Collins, C-O-L-L-I-N-S, Harry, H-A-R-R-Y, and Trevor Pinch, T-R-E-V-O-R-P-I-N-C-H. These two people so beautifully tell you how the whole science is an edifice, an establishment to cheat us and keep us under the crowd and then frighten us, saying that without science you can't live, and then keep us under their control. The third world country people, the colonies, to be under their control. That was the intention of what is called the original science of Newtonian, Einsteinian worldview of two dimensions, space and time. We believe that. We teach that even today in our schools and colleges, which has been proved wrong nearly 100 years ago. Year was 1925 when Einstein's own student in the Zurich Polytechnic told him, your science is, you're talking through your hat. All that science is gone. And whatever you've been talking, all the Nobel Prize that you get, you know, everybody gets a Nobel Prize, provided you're anti-Indian and pro-West and pro-science.